My name is Colin Donahue, and I'm a field ecologist at Yale University. My team and I recently published a study in functional ecology focusing on a wall lizard in the Greek archipelago. Lizard traits can change depending on conditions, like if predators are present or if food is abundant or scarce. The question we asked for this study was whether lizard bite forces changed across islands of different sizes. We suspect it would change because bite force is related to what a lizard can eat and how well it can fend off other lizards. We predicted that on small islands, lizards would have a stronger bite force because a stronger bite force could enable them to eat harder diet items like snails when food is less abundant, or the harder bite force could enable that lizard to defend a territory better against other lizards. The perfect place to answer this question was in the Greek Cyclades because of the wide range in island sizes and the abundance of the local wall lizard, Podarces erhardii. All summer, my team and I took a ferry and often kayaked from island to island catching lizards. Over the summer, we caught several hundred lizards and looked at their diets and quantified the levels of lizard-on-lizard aggression between populations. After analyzing all the data, we found that lizards on small islands did have stronger bites than lizards on large islands. And second, that these lizards were using their bites more to ward off other lizards than to gain access to harder food. This research gives us new insight into not just how lizards differ from place to place, but also why. This finding is important because it gives us new information on how the context around a species, in this case the abundance of food or the density of competitors, affects a functionally important ecological trait, bite force.